championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
What's up, Lakers Nation? It's your boy, Matt the Optimist Peralta, here with you today to talk about someone near and dear to my heart. Judging by the video title, you've already guessed it. It's Chaundee Brown. But before I get into it, make sure that you subscribe to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and that you click the bell so you can get videos like these right as they come out. So, Chaundee Brown. The Lakers have a valuable prospect in Chaundee, a 3-and-D wing, 6'5", 215 pounds, who's shown flashes already. And guess what? They've got an extra two-way contract. Yes, if you remember, the Lakers signed Austin Reeves and Joel Ayayi after they both went undrafted to two-way contracts. However, Reeves impressed enough for the Lakers to ultimately commit a standard NBA deal with him, which means that they have an open two-way spot. So, the Lakers could approach this a couple different directions where they could look outside for a prospect that hasn't been signed yet, or they can simply look within. And guess what? Chaundee Brown's sitting right there. So, should the Lakers do it? Should they sign Chaundee to the other two-way contract? The short answer is yes. I think they should. Two-way contracts are a low-risk, high-reward move. You know, it doesn't cost the Lakers much in terms of cap space. Two-way contracts allow them to evaluate players on a deeper level because this year, they're allowed to spend 50 games with the parent team. Before, they were restricted on days, you know, including travel and practices. But this year, that's no longer the case. Two-way contract players are allowed to spend up to 50 games with the parent roster, but then they can still shuffle between the G League affiliate as well. So in this case, Joel Ayayi, who's still on a two-way deal, can go back and forth between the Lakers and South Bay in terms of playing games and his development. Now, why do I think the Lakers should sign Chaundee to that two-way contract? I think the first thing we have to point out here is the 3-and-D wing depth on the Lakers currently. Okay, Trevor Ariza is going to be out for 8 weeks after undergoing ankle surgery, which makes them incredibly thin at forward already. I know they've got Kent Bazemore. I know LeBron James can guard wing still. Anthony Davis can hang out on the perimeter. But after those three guys, the Lakers don't really have a lot there. So, Chaundee Brown, what kind of player is he for those who haven't really been watching? Well, he's 6'5". He can guard threes. He can guard fours. You know, he's not afraid of bigger players. He can mix it up. Plays with a lot of energy and hustle and heart, which is why I personally really like him. But also, aside from the defense, he has shown a knack for hitting open threes. At Michigan in his senior year, shot nearly 42% from distance. And so far in the NBA, it looks like that's translating when he's got an open look and time to set his feet and actually get his jump shot in order. So, with that being said, that alone already to me makes him an intriguing fit. Also, the thing working in his favor as well is that head coach Frank Vogel also seems to think that he's making an impression. I've written an article for LakersNation.com where Frank Vogel talks about Chaundee Brown and what he's brought to the table so far, and it sounds like Vogel's a fan, just like me. And we all know that the head coach has a pretty big say in the roster construction here, so if Frank Vogel's already taken notice of Chaundee Brown, I have to think that he's the front runner for that other two-way spot. I do want to mention, however, though, that the Lakers, again, like I mentioned at the top of the video, can go a different direction and sign someone else to that two-way if they choose so. I know that a lot of people are already pegging Sekou Doumbouya as a potential target for that two-way contract after he was waived, and I don't blame you because he's an intriguing prospect, and I'm surprised as well that he's out there. So the Lakers could go in that direction if they choose to. However, I think that what we've seen from Chaundee Brown already warrants a bigger look or a longer look from the team. And I also just think, you know, his development and his long-term outlook are so good that it'd be crazy for them not to do it. Maybe I'm just biased because I love the guy. I love watching him play. But I do think that he's earned an opportunity for a two-way deal in the NBA. And I think the Lakers would be wise to do so. But that's just my opinion. In the comments below, tell me what you guys think. Do you think Chaundee Brown deserves that extra two-way spot, or should it go to someone else? There's one right answer here, but I'll let you guys figure it out. But that's all I have for today. So until next time, Lakers Nation, Optimist out.